Yo, what's up guys, welcome back. Thank you so much for tuning in and I appreciate you guys taking your time and tuning to my YouTube channel. So I'm back again today with another video, and in today's video we're going to be looking at the Apple MacBook Pro 13 inch, the 2020 version. So that's the device that I have here with me, and we're just going to take a quick look on it and see how it looks and feel, and I'll take you down through the specifications and everything that comes with it. So let's just go ahead and seal it. We've taken it out of the box already, and this is how it looks. So I'm gonna break all this thing together, and then this is the laptop itself. So this is smaller than the 15 inch that I'm currently using, so this is 13 inch in size. And the accessories that it comes with, apart from the paperwork, this is the power brick, same power brick that you get in on the MacBook Pro 15 inch, as well as the Thunderbolt connector, which you can connect to any port. So let me take you down through the specifications of this MacBook, starting with the external features and the specification that you can actually see from the laptop. So the one that I have here with me in particular, this is like a high-end customized specifications that you get with the MacBook 13 inch. So basically you get the two Thunderbolt port on each side of the laptop. On the left hand side you get a two on this side and another two, and then together with the audio jack on the right hand side of the laptop. So if you get in like a base model or a standard model or like an 8 gig RAM one, you won't get this two Thunderbolt on each side. So you get one Thunderbolt on each side, as well as the audio jack on the other side of the laptop. So going down through the internal specification of this one in particular, so this one has a 16 gig RAM, and then it has a 1 terabyte SSD storage, and then it has a Core i5 10th generation. So this actually makes it more expensive than a normal 8th generation of the Core i5 processor. So it's actually a huge difference in terms of the price. We'll go down through the price shortly. And then going down into the laptop itself, this one comes in with a touch bar and the touch ID. And what I like about this is the touch ID is actually separated from the skip key, as well as separated from the touch ID that you're actually using to start up the laptop. I still love this form factor because it's light in weight. You can actually work with it anywhere, and it's good for productivity, and you don't have to actually worry about the weight and carrying it in your bag. And it's small and compatible, and then they still have the speakers on the side that actually produce like a great sound. The touchpad, because this is a 13 inch, it's a bit small. I'm used to the bigger one that I have on my 15 inch. But however, the functionality and everything is still good. So one thing I like about Apple products when it comes into their touch ID, it's how much you can customize it and tell which tap does which function. It's actually very, very impressive. Still comes in with a 720p webcam. I know most of us were expecting to get like maybe 1080 or a 4K. I mean, Apple makes some of the great smartphone cameras, so I believe that they're capable of doing same thing into their MacBook. One, this comes in with the Catalina macOS, which is the OS that's running in here. And then, like I said, still comes in with the Touch ID with Siri compatibility. And then in terms of the price, this one in particular goes in for 45,000 Rand from iStore, and I will link the link in the description section below. So thank you so much guys for tuning in, and this was just a quick look on the new 2020 MacBook Pro 13 inch. And I'll see you guys on my next video. Bye.